In this lecture, we're finally bringing together everything we have learned so far, and we're going to be creating our first dashboard. So far, we had a look at various components of Tableau and how to create effective visualizations. So we looked at pulling data from the various sources into a worksheet, looked at various parameters, filtering, sorting, grouping options, and we explored some of the different data visualization components that you can use, charts, tables, and so forth. So it's been a long road to get here, but the good news is that once we have created all the charts and tables, so once we've created different worksheets, it's a relatively quick and simple process to create a dashboard. Before you embark on creating your dashboard, you need to have a think about what sort of questions your users might be interested in finding out the answers to. Then you need to create a number of coherent worksheets which will represent the data in different ways, and together, when placed on the dashboard, will give insight to your user. And the simple motto of less is more definitely applies here. Just because you have 10 different worksheets that you've worked on, don't necessarily try to use all of them and cram them all onto the dashboard. You need to look for the right balance, and usually 3 to 4 worksheets is more than enough. Otherwise, your dashboard becomes too busy and the user is faced with information overload. Just remember to keep your dashboards clean and simple. Okay, so let's have a look at creating a dashboard. Here we have a workbook that I prepared earlier, and this workbook has five different sheets, and it has each sheet has a particular data visualization. So we have, again, we're looking at the sales. So first tab or first sheet is sales by customer segment. Then we have a profit by state, so we have a mapping visualization. We have percentage of total sales. Now this one actually is using a table calculation. And we have top 10 product lines. So we have a variety of visualizations. We want to put them onto one dashboard. Now, it doesn't matter whether your individual sheets connecting to the same data connection or they are completely independent. That does not stop you, or does not prevent you from using them on the same data visualization. So if you're using different sources, that's all okay, and your worksheets can be completely independent of each other. Okay, so to create a dashboard, there's two options. We can go to the top and we can click on New Dashboard, or you can go down to the bottom and click on a Dashboard tab. So clicking on that opens up dashboard interface. So this interface is slightly different than the interface for creating worksheets. So when we're working with dashboards, we're actually not working with data itself. So we're actually working with the worksheets and other elements that you can place on a dashboard. So the interface is different, and we have different options on the left-hand side. So on the top, we have a list of all the sheets that are present in our workbook, which we can drag onto our dashboard main area. Now you can see here we got one called Sheet 5, and this sort of illustrates the need to properly name your sheets. Otherwise, you don't know exactly what's going on. We don't know what Sheet 5 is. So this is a list of sheets, top left. Next thing underneath that, we have a listing of other objects we can drag onto the dashboard. So we can drag horizontal, vertical containers, free text where you can type in whatever you need to. So you can also drag an image, which you might want to include your company logo, a web page if you have a particular link you want to display within the dashboard, for example, a wiki page that might have explanations of your various data elements in more detail, or you can just have a blank space as well, which you might use for working with the layouts and so forth. Now everything on the dashboard is placed within containers, and containers are what makes up the layout of a dashboard. So the containers can be tiled, which means Tableau is actually taking control of how they're laid out on the main dashboard, or they can be floating, which means that you get more control and you can place it wherever you want on the dashboard. But it's a little bit harder to maintain, especially as things move around. So we'll leave it tiled for now. The next pane is a layout pane, which lists all the different containers and elements that are part of your dashboard. At the moment, obviously, it's blank, but we'll come back to this in a second. And the last pane is a dashboard pane, where you can control the size of the dashboard and where you can choose to include the title or not. Now, there's a number of preset sizes. So if you know your audience and you know the devices they will be using, you can choose one of these. So let's say they want to use iPads, you would choose the iPad size. You can also manually change things around, and but you can also leave it up to Tableau to manage, so by setting it to automatic. Okay, so those are the different options that you can have with the dashboard. There's a couple more that we'll visit later on, but for now let's actually build one. So we'll start by dragging some of the worksheets onto the main area. So here's the first one. So you can see that the little tick is next to the worksheet, which means that it's now being included in the dashboard. We can drag another one. So by holding the button without releasing it, you can actually control where the sheet will be dropped. So profit by state, let's say we want to drop it on top. Percentage of sales, we might put it right next to it. And top 10 products, let's make it like this. So it's nice and symmetric. So as you can see, Tableau does a pretty good job of managing space. Tableau allows you to move things around once they're on the dashboard, obviously, so you can actually highlight a particular worksheet and drag it into a different area. So let's say we want to move it down here, which doesn't look very good, so we'll put it back. Once the worksheet is on the dashboard, there are a couple of other things you can control with it. So obviously with this one here, percentage of total sales, the data is actually too big to be displayed all in one go. So we can actually make it wider, or we can increase its height, or you can actually allow Tableau to manage it. So by choosing, by selecting the container and choosing fit height or fit width or entire view, which actually tries to include all of the information into a single view, so there's no scrolling around. So in addition, Tableau has actually brought in filters and legends from some of the underlying worksheets, and by default it places them in the rightmost container, and by default they're tiled. So in some cases, it actually makes sense to move these elements closer to the data visualization. So for example, our profit legend will be better placed right next to the map. And we can do that by actually going to selecting a little drop-down context menu and going to change the layout to be, instead of tiled, changing it to floating, which means now we can actually move this legend wherever we want. So it would make sense to include it next on the chart, and now it's actually laid on top of the chart. Now you have to be careful with floating elements, because as things move around, for example, if we were adjusting that, the floating element will remain in its place, so you have to readjust its position. So going back to the layout pane, now that we've placed several elements onto the dashboard, you can actually see how they're organized by clicking on the traversing the tree, the layout tree. So the overall container is tiled, it's broken down into two horizontal panes. The one on the left hand side is tiled and it contains these worksheets and so forth. So you can actually, one thing you can do with these containers, so for example, I'm clicking on the vertical container here, which is actually a container that contains the filter and this legend. We can actually format it and we can do things like change its background and so forth. Okay, so let's show you a couple other quick things you can do with your dashboard. So we spoke about earlier about adding elements which are not worksheets. So let's try and add a free text element, so maybe we'll use it as a title to our dashboard. So it's easy as you know, adding worksheets. So we just drag it from a list of elements onto our dashboard, and we'll give it a name. And we can also do some basic formatting around here. So let's make that maybe slightly bigger and centered, and maybe we'll make it red. And the element is now placed in our dashboard. Now this is an example of where Tableau will need a little bit of our help to actually work out the layout, because obviously the title is not placed properly. So we'll make it a little bit, we'll reduce its height so that we can see other elements on the dashboard as well. So now from here you can actually fine-tune things a little bit more. For example, within this worksheet here, we can see the order date is kind of taking a little bit of real estate, but it's not necessarily required for the label to be within the table itself, because we know that these years actually are related to the order dates. So to actually make an adjustment, what you can do is actually go to the worksheet. So you can jump back onto the percentage total sales worksheet via tab at the bottom. Or the other option is, if you go back to dashboard, is actually following a little shortcut in the top right corner. So clicking on that will take you to the worksheet. And in here we can adjust our label, and we can actually hide the field label for column, which will remove the order date. And then going back to the dashboard, you can see that it's actually gone from there as well, which, you know, allows us to claim a bit more of real estate. One thing you can do also as a quick tip, if your workbook is getting quite large, so you have a large number of worksheets and dashboards and so forth within the workbook, you can actually hide them by, you know, right-clicking on the tab and hiding a sheet. The sheet now does not show in the bottom, but you can still get to it from your dashboard by clicking on Go to Sheet label. So it will appear briefly or while you're working on it, and then going back to dashboard, it will disappear. But, you know, it's still within your workbook and you can get to it. So this wraps up our brief introduction to dashboards. In the next lecture, we'll have a look at how to make these dashboards a little bit more interactive, and we'll be looking at using actions to achieve that result.